So, Confine the Desktop part 51 already, and at this point, it's July 11, I made some changes that I have not recorded, very little though. But anyways, when I upgraded the system to Fedora 19, there were a couple of bugs that were introduced with Fedora 19. And some bugs you couldn't see in the screencast, and some of you could. So for example, I had this issue with my screen freezing every second, or not every second, but every once in a while for a second. And it wasn't anything that serious, but it was very annoying and wouldn't be good to record with that bug. But anyways, today I updated libDRM and libX11 from Fedora updates, and that seems to have fixed that issue. So that's why I'm back now and not earlier. There are some other issues as well that may have an effect on one of our previous sessions. For example, there's currently an update to a GNOME terminal in Fedora updates. And we previously did actually update the GNOME terminal policy for Fedora 19, because there was a big change in the Fedora 19 GNOME terminal, or GNOME 3.8 GNOME terminal package. No, excuse my coughing also, because it's a bad day for my bronchitis. It's cloudy, and so that's not right. But anyway, so that's definitely a change that and might actually affect, because I added that policy, and maybe that wasn't that right. Another issue there was that since Fedora 19 upgrade, I added a lot of rules that allow domains to read/write some stuff. Should I actually show you that? SSH Dominic. I need to log on anyways. Netkb info. So cd my login user. there's some issue with GDM, and then nano my login user te should be able to find it. Almost every domain needs it. I need not a service. Do you depress? Might actually need that. Where is that rule that relates to that GDM leak? But anyways, I was actually looking at some bugzillas, and in Fedora there was actually also the bug was also reported, and turns out that is a leak, because Chrome was actually needing to mess with GDM. Now where the hell? Is it an example? Oh, I need an example. When you're looking for it, you'll always see that you won't find it as so easily. A seahorse. Also not. GPT maybe. Also not. That's annoying, just when you need it. I haven't added it to all domains, so you'll see it come back over and over again. Damned. That's really annoying. Just let him just go down. Well, I can't spend too much time on this shit. Oh, here it is. Here's an example of that rule. A read write to Unix string socket. And the weird thing is that Fedora actually has a rule that silently hides or silently denies any domain to read write Unix stream sockets of any other domain, but somehow that still pops up. But anyways, so this is a rule that is related to a bug actually, so I can actually remove that or don't audit that, or actually don't audit. I'm not sure if that's going to work, but anyways, that's one of the other issues. The other issue is that I actually figured out that I did something really that I misunderstood the audit access permission. Now this is a really weird permission that basically is used to, let me first explain that access, checking access on a file is in SELinux represented the same as actually accessing the file in that way. So if you check for write, then from an SELinux perspective, you'll get a write. You need a write permission, but the actual syscall is different, the Linux syscall. So there's this issue by, for example, with Nautilus, where Nautilus does a shitload of checks on your stuff in your home directory to see if it can access it, and then it basically shows a label on the icon. If it can't access it, it shows a cross or a lock on it and stuff like that. So there needed to be a way, at least someone thought there needed to be a way to basically don't audit those access checks, but still make it visible when Nautilus actually tries to access the content. So for example, if Nautilus does a check for execute on a file, we would want to be able to silently deny that. But if it want to actually execute that file, we want to actually be able to see it, that it actually tries to execute the file, and that's where that audit access permission comes in, that allows us to create a rule that says don't audit some domain, or actually don't audit Nautilus some file audit access. For example, read, write, or execute, checking that, and then we can basically just load that, and then it will just don't audit any access checks. But if it actually tries to execute, read, or write Nautilus in that case, then it will actually audit it. So that will allow us to just don't audit that stuff, and we don't have to worry that we are not going to see it when it actually wants to do that. So I did change that in the policy for Nautilus at least, and actually I also changed that for another Nautilus component, but I haven't actually fixed that all the way in the everywhere in the policy. So this is here. So basically, where is it? Don't audit. Where am I? Don't audit. Now these are different. You get attributes and reads. Well, actually, this should probably, this might probably also, oh yeah, this is it. So this can basically be removed because this was old, but yeah, that's basically that. So I could probably do the same here. So I will move read from this one here. Let's see if that works. Not sure if that actually works, and if not, I'll see that. And then edit out at access here. If Nautilus just checks for read, then it will be silently denied. If it actually reads those files, which I don't think that it does, because if it does, then it would probably open the stuff also, and it doesn't. We need to just keep an eye on that and just fix that over everywhere, because I just abused, or I just misunderstood how that stuff works. So there's now here's the same stuff, I guess, but this is now to listen to, and I'm not saying that domains or programs shouldn't check for do access checks. They usually do that for a good reason, so usually you shouldn't actually don't audit that. But in the case of Nautilus, that's just a special case, because Nautilus just does that for those stupid icons. So there's no actual it's actually a good idea to just don't audit those. But in general, if someone tries to do an access check, then you should allow that. And that's another thing to keep in mind, is that the audit access factor permission only works with the don't audit access factor. So you can't say allow some domain, some file type, file, and then audit access. That doesn't change, that doesn't work. And that's, if you think about it, that's actually, it's a very weird access factor, because it really is, in some cases, just don't seem to make sense. And it worked for me without using it, the audit access factor, because I just don't audit the actual permission related to the check. So, and that worked for me. But since now I know how to use it, I just decided to use that. It's that same stuff. Oh, this is Nautilus, actually. So could do that here as well. So don't audit the audit access. But really don't audit get attribute. I just need to see if that actually is going to work. Now, with regard to GNOME Shell. Shell is actually doing the same stuff, and with regard to GNOME Shell, it's probably a different story, and I'm not actually sure, I haven't checked it. But GNOME Shell also does these checks on executable files, and I actually think that GNOME Shell, I haven't confirmed that, but I think it does those checks on those executable files, and if it basically fails the check, that it doesn't show up on the menu. I'm not actually sure if that's really the case, but that's what I think it uses it for. I'm not actually sure about that though. But it does those access checks. So that would be actually also a nice feature for GNOME Shell, because if GNOME Shell doesn't have access to it, then why freaking show up in the menu? It doesn't make sense. So let's just go to GNOME Shell, G Shell, and we might just add a rule for that. So here we have this other test, but we actually allow those, and to be honest, to be honest, it doesn't make sense to allow those, because it is weird though. We need to really actually review this stuff. For because with regard to GNOME Shell, actually, it is just friggin' messy. This, see, these programs, some of these shells already allowed to actually run with a domain transition. So, for some of this, it's just already no longer needed. So let's say, for example, File Roller, it's already allowed to run that. Data prefs, it's already allowed to run it. Gsysmon, Events, Eye of Gnome. Now this one isn't. GTK, it is already allowed to do that. And the same goes for example, Nautilus. It's already allowed to run Nautilus. I'm not sure if it's allowed to run Baobab. Is that stupid? Yeah, probably. But not Autorun yet. And Terminal. And that's actually also not the case, because it's at least not in the new Fedora, new GNOME. So, and then this here, Chainsaw, these are stuff that it can't actually execute yet. So we need to actually allow those for now. And then we can basically just add a rule that says don't audit my login user g shell t binty file. And then actually audit access. So that doesn't show up, so to speak, on when it tries to access it, doesn't show up in the menu. That's a good thing. At least it's probably a good thing. But anyways, there's a lot of stuff in there that probably still have outed access that I should just remove, because it doesn't make sense. I should basically just look for outed access all over the place and just only use it where it makes sense. So here, for example, Nautilus search provider. Now this isn't the problem, is that I actually don't know needed that. So I'll just for now make a comment, because I forgot what I changed actually. Now this doesn't make sense. But it's for right actually. And this also probably a good thing to don't add it, because let's consider this. Why would File Roller check the user home directories for write? I guess it probably would do that to see if it can actually write to it. Now if it can write to it, then it's allowed to write to it, then it's already here. So basically the maybe it just tries to be smart and just does the checks and says, okay, I'm not allowed to write to it, so I'm not going to allow in the graphical user interface the user to press the save button or the extract to button. So in this case, it might actually also make sense to basically don't audit this. You need to be very careful. It kind of blows my mind the use of this, but in this case might actually also be useful. Now here in Nautilus, this is great. This is what we decided to do. And we can remove that comment because now I know how it works. Don't out it. This is also, I just changed that recently. I'm not actually sure. But I'll leave that in. So some of the stuff just confused me. Here we have Baobab actually for read. So this is an actual read probably. And it's already allowed here. So this doesn't make sense. Oh, it's actually, this is for a file. Why would it read a file? Here we have another stupid thing. GVFS recent. So this probably just says, okay, if I can't read write to it, then I probably just shouldn't show it up in the recents, I guess. I should probably allow that. It's very confusing. Yeah, here's the same stuff. Actually, I already did that here. GVFS the recent. Then why? How does this change anything? Actually, this is great. We don't want stuff to show up. Like this, we can allow, I guess. But the one above, we should just don't add it. Because we want to actually We don't want stuff with generic of with private types showing up in the recent in the recent menu. We only want generic content that we recently accessed to show up there, because generally the user doesn't have access to any non-generic user home content. And the user home directory can actually be removed here. And I can actually probably move this where it, where the remainder is. And this is allowed. So it's kind of a mess with regard to that stuff. Here we have init script file type allow out of access, doesn't make sense. Yeah, that's right. So you need really need to be careful with those checks. You need to probably usually allow them, but only in special cases, don't audit them. So in this case, I previously don't audit it to execute for dbus to shell exec, and that really changed the whole behavior, because dbus said, okay, I can't execute a shell, so then this functionality is not going to work. And then later I allowed it, and then a whole new, basically a whole different set of functionality was unlocked, because it said, okay, I can execute it, so now I can do actually do that. So you need to be really careful there. Same here. See? Once you just check execute, so let's just allow that. G-shell, bint, yeah. Gconf D. So here, it wants to check if config is writable, so just allow that. And it might actually change the whole damn scenario. It's just checking for write. Here now to the service provider. I did this recently. Now, I'll just do this. This needs to be able to read write as well. This else stuff will not show up. Mess. I think we're now about through them. Yeah, I think that's about it. So let's see if this builds. And it doesn't. Don't audit. Another done audit. Jesus. Or am I not able to save it? Yeah, I'm not able to save it. Weird. You kidding me? I was able to save it. So yeah, it's just a little messy currently. Shit. Okay, so I'll just require that somewhere above. Or actually, but at least at Nautilus though. Now here it's the same shit. Nautilus is... The Nautilus is allowed to run file roller, so it's already allowed access. With regard to others, Eye of Gnome. It's probably already allowed to do that. It's just basically checking to see if it can execute that file. So that they can show it up in the Nautilus screen. Same with data prefs and data depth. Messi. Christ. Very fucked up. Whatever. Now there's probably not an outlet access for each and every one of those. Just try it out. Really fucked up and messy. And for what? It was working fine before. Probably out access probably not applied to FIFAs and to SOCs either. Really messy this. No, it does want to build. So yeah, that's really, you really need to be careful how to use that, because if you use it wrong, then shit could hit the fan. But if you don't use it, then you'll get a wrong representation, wrong stuff. So anyways, let's just log in and see where it gets us. I'm trying to focus on fixing GNOME System Manager, but before that I will really want to check out and see let's first just check out a little bit of those outlet accesses. And this is not the right one, for Christ's sake. And it already starts bussing. Have you seen else? Obsession also does these access checks. And Shell wants to actually do a file execute. So let's have a look at that. Data. Here we have it. No, it's just an XOK. Oh yeah, that's because. But we need to disallow that. So it actually does a check, but we just don't output the X checks for. God damn it. So that isn't actually allowed to run data directly. And that's why it's busting out this, because it does want to check it, and we should actually tell it that it's there. Now, with regard to G session. Well, I'll be goddamned. Bad day, guys. Here we have. So we. Basically, we allow it to. It's basically checking all these session stuffs. So we have some session stuff that are generic, and it's trying to check that. But if it's generic, then it shouldn't run it. It's not able to access it. So that's fine. So this should actually be added. So these, it can check. It's the start PA and the restore con and the HP and the outlet, because these can be actually from the session menu. You can activate, for example, and tell it okay, run restore con when you start a session. And the shell, that's just something I guess he just needs to check, so we also allow that. But everything that's generic, we say okay, don't allow it to check that access, so that probably at that point it just doesn't show up in the menu for session G session properties. I don't know if we have that G session properties. See, now it just doesn't show up much. Because, well, GNOME can test it for some reason, and that basically means that it doesn't show them up in the menu. It just basically says, okay, if I can't access it, then I shouldn't actually put it in the menu anyways. So that's why a lot of this stuff just doesn't show up. And that's nice, because now you can basically actually make GNOME in a way that it only shows up the stuff that you can actually access. And that's actually great. That's actually a great feature. If you use it right. And it does make the stuff really a bit more complex. So you really have to actually, by default you can actually say, okay, don't audit the audit check and then start allowing stuff that it should be able to run. So in theory, everything that shows up here should be runnable. Now, the settings, I don't think that's currently actually runnable. But it does already have a type, so we should we already declared a type for it, and we did already allow GNOME Shell to actually check for access. So GNOME Shell thinks that we should, that we can run this, but we can't actually run it. So that's another thing that. So now that actually starts to make sense to me. It's just so stupid complex that. So that's why it's just so such an empty desktop, because basically, it's not allowed. It checks a lot of stuff and it says, okay, I can't access it. So why should I put it up in the menu if I can't access it anyways? So let's just SE module. Let's just actually check some of the existing stuff. So the shell should work. And it does. Why isn't anyway, shell should work, get enforce. We haven't actually updated the shell to the latest version, the terminal to the latest version. So that stuff seems to actually work. So I should just and this need to be that's weird. I thought I allowed that. I'm gonna copy this over as well. So it's actually executing some. Well, that's. I'll be damned. Did I actually load that up in the system? Probably not. Okay, gterm. I still have kind of confused now. Oh, I just did it as a module DB, didn't I? No, I didn't. Weird. So let's try this again, and then as a module B, just to be sure. And then 11:31. Yeah, we have bad weather, cloudy, and it's going to rain or something. So. It's really, the summer really sucks here. You have some very hot days and then the next day it's cool and very wet, and so it's a bad day, a bad country to live for someone that has bronchitis or something like that. So 11:31. Now let's try this again. It's D term D actually. Now we'll allow it to signal. We won't allow it. Oh, and set PGID get PGID, but we won't allow it to. Signal in hand. Damn. I'm really rusty. I are really rusty. It's been a while since I last actually worked on it. Oh, and I so I need to just be careful because I'm just not thinking properly. That looks okay. Okay, so 3-4. Clean. Try this again. Now we're clean. Okay, so let's just open up this stuff and show hidden files. So it's still looking the way I expected it, and then I focus on the labels on the icons, so it shows. But it is actually trying to read. So this is not an access check. It's actually listing these directories. And you can see that, and I should interpret that. See? Open read only. So if this is not a check. The check is for write, I guess. Where did I add that stuff? Where did I add that stuff? Christ's sake. And there's some duplicates in there as well. It's really messy. It's really messy. Yeah. So I just need to don't edit this one here, use a home type. And it's actually weird. So it's checking and it knows it can't access it and still it wants to access those. So that means that it really actually wants to do that. And that doesn't make sense. Same here, it's actually real. Let's just go through this. So homebrew tea. I just don't want it to list home. Should it be able to list SSH? It might actually need to do that, although I don't see why. I don't see why it should be able to read. Gconf does actually wants to, yeah, so that's so weird. Where is it traversing home with D already? Got to be somewhere here. Yeah. don't want to allow that stuff. Qigong. Very confusing. Qigong, it should open that, I guess, because it's traversing that for data. And I already allowed that. So that basically will just say, okay, but don't read GPT secret SSH home T and home root T. So that's really confusing, this stuff. What should I allow? What should I don't audit for a check or audit for an actual access for an open? Really confusing. So it's really still just it really wants to list, seems. I notify at watch. It seems to really want that, else it's going to float like a hell. So I just need to actually allow it to read. But not try not to open it. Oh, actually. Try and see if it can do without open. who just really wants to read that stuff for some reason. Now it's actually also opening it, this stuff. So it's opening for cache and keyconf as I expected, kind of. Really nasty. Really, really nasty. Okay, so you don't audit it open for homebrew tea, and then don't audit, oh, and this property file that should be allowed. So now this kernel read system state. Kernel read system state my login user now key, and then user of homebrew T, where the fuck is it, homebrew T, and I'm in enforcer mode, so how in the hell? Nasty. Except for example, mount. But for now, mount. So what I want to do, read proc, we allowed that. Open homebrew tea, we denied that because I don't like that. Now it wants to actually read var, list var. Why would it want to list var, but it actually wants that pretty bad. Does it 2 times in a row. And temp, it's actually trying to list temp. Amount, well, amount makes sense. Try this again. It's pretty damn ugly. So some of that stuff is actually related to update from 3.6 to 3.8. And other stuff is actually for Christ's sake. It's getting really sensitive. Look, it wants to get all process state. None of its business though. Drop IRQ. guessed it, of course. Oh, Colonel Reed's dead. No. Colonel... sure if that's actually going to build. No. It's gonna take a little while because I'm just messing up the main. Don't either get attributes. Actually, I'll get all domain state. Let's try this. But it's probably not enough. Probably wants to read everything like a dog in heat. Get attribute all domain state. Why should it want to do that? That's just bullshit. But I'll just allow it anyways. Guess it has a good reason to do that. Guess I have to rely on that. Okay, now let's see what time we have it. 12:01. Okay, so I'm back. Oh yeah, right. So it wants to read the user state. That's right. And I have that somewhere. This is about state. And then go to node. Oops. And then just allow Nautilus to also read the user state. Because the user is not a domain. I need to look this shit up. I need to look that up because I think it actually wants to read it and I could just grab those. Well, this is better. Ref policy. Open directory. Policy. Modules. Kernel. And then, I guess device. Let's see if there's, if the proc8 core is there. Let's just try it anyways. So it's not there, so where is it? Maybe kernel? Get that to read core in phase. Read core in phase. Let's just do this for now. It's just really messy. Nope, 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 nope. bad day for policy development, I guess. So you can't actually get attributes of IRQ syscontrols. Proc K message. Proc MD stat. So there's just no get attributes for that, so I just have to do with reads, I guess. Else I would have to create them and don't feel like that. To see where that gets me. Yeah, let's just clean again. Nothing. Log in again. Clean. So that's probably a little bit more permissive than it should be. oh, actually, why the hell am I now using interfaces? That's just stupid. All of a sudden, I'm starting to use a readable policy. That's not what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm gonna read system state. Really a bad day for policy writing. So this, I'm gonna have to do this all over again. Frog type. Can't believe that porting this stuff is just so complicated. So what is the does file system type actually exist? Does exist, and why the fuck is there an 5310 and I was 5302? And again, tried. All of a sudden, I was starting writing a readable policy. That's not what I'm supposed to be doing. Should be using raw policy. And again, control type. So let's get attribute of proc type, file system types, and this is control types. And it's there actually. Fuck. Me. 12:24. Let's browse a little bit. Nothing. It can't. That's good. Does that show any exit now, though? Shouldn't. No. So that looks at least a little bit clean. You can basically browse the stuff a little bit. Okay, now that Nautilus seems okay, I guess. At least it seems clean. At least it seems clean, so that's fine, I guess, for now. Okay, so now let's just see if we can make a system monitor to work. Hopefully that's easy, but it's probably not easy. Nothing ever is. Well, let's just try it out to see what's going on. So, system monitor, where are you? Here. Boom. So here it is. Let's see what IFC denials we get. And it's Sysmon is also here you have that leak, but other than that it's all, it's okay. Well, with regard to get it, so it gets attribute and then it tries to execute, it checks it for execute. So let's just change that. But other than that, I don't see much. Where I take server stuff here. So there's that stuff related to that leak. And now all of a sudden it's trying to also trying to it's also trying to be smart. I should really just anyways, don't audit. Jesus, man. Actually, Binti. Foul. Why are these cocksuckers trying to check everything for execute? I don't understand that. I don't understand that at all. Let's just actually out of access. And here we have Sysmon, he was chatting. Sysmon is chatting to GNOME Shell. That's in theory. Makes stuff work in theory. It's doing those nasty checks again. It's all over the system. It's trying to determine what it should display and what it shouldn't display, I guess. Trying to be smart. SE module B. Get me some mail, I guess. Let's just close it first. And 7-4-1. And I'll search. Clean there, so should it run? Will it run? And it does run. So I guess we made at least some progress. Now as for the processes, it does show them actually. See what we got. Nothing. Great. Fine. So that's fixed as well. So at least we fixed something. Better than nothing. Let's see if volume monitor works. Probably not, nothing works probably. G4mon, or what is it called? It's not even showing up. Oh, this one is it. Seems to work at least a little bit. Are you kidding me? Am I not? Am I enforcing? I am enforcing. Okay, so this works as well, I guess. At least to some extent. Let's see, what else do we have? Transmission. Do we have any AFC denials relation to just booting it? Nope. Seems to work. At least the shallow test. Signals related to that. We have one TR extract. Didn't even know that TR extract. It's getting attribute of FS of extended attributes of FS. So it's called TR extract. TR extract. So we're getting then allow file system type, file system get attribute. This basically allows it to get attribute of any file system. Maybe a little bit too coarse, maybe not. But yeah, it seems we're at least advancing a little bit. But this is, yeah, this is just weird. It just only shows up some stuff, the bare minimums. Does document view help works? Yep, help works. It's old. Let's test that a little bit. So let's print this page. Print the file. Documents output. Print preview. Does it work? Seems to work. Print again. Print the file. Print. Okay. Let's have a look. AFC denials. No. Seems to work. Let's open that up in my stuff here. Here we have a PDF. It's getting generated. Open in document viewer. Seems to work. None ABC denials yet, so that's all fine and dandy so far. So that's at least that didn't change. That's something. That works. What else do we have? System log. I think I disabled that. Let's just try it. Should work. See, my SSH is DDoSed a lot, DDoSed or DDoSed. Here we have some AFC denials. Getting attribute of user temp t. So this is not quite right yet. But at least it seems to work. But we need to basically clean that up. Buggy as hell. So document view retested passwords. So let's just 45 that. Seahorse wants to set attributes ibis config empty. So let's just change that. Where are you? Seems that Seahorse doesn't do any ibis yet at all. Need to fix that. Find something that does ibis. This is ibis. So I'll apply that to Seahorse, I guess. Add name can be removed, get attribute to search can be, this whole stuff can be removed. And I should take care of that. So I'm just cleaning up the stuff. And I'm doing it in a chaotic way. I'm just trying out stuff and just see if it works. And cleaning up as I go. Except for log viewer, I just neglected that for now. So this is allowed now. What else do we have? Image viewer seems to work, at least on the surface. Do we have desktop sharing? And here we have GTK. So Vino Preps wants to do the GTK dance, and Vino D as well, though. Vino Preps and Vino D. Oh. Wow, 45 degrees, so something is Lagging. Oh, be damned. What do we have with regard to GTK? Nothing yet, but okay. Obviously they need to do those bookmark things or other stuff with regard to GTK. Or maybe it's just something in the root. No, it's not something in the root, so it's actually something in config. Make modules. PS aux wrap my logins. VinoD is actually running. So yeah, that seems to at least work a little bit. But if you do this really carefully, then you really get a nice functionality. Let's see if this gives us anything. At 53, I guess. Because now, in theory, if I did it right, then I would have only I only see the menu items that I'm actually able to use. So if I add now a new, see, there's no Firefox in the menu because it can't actually, because GNOME can't actually check for execute. And so it says, okay, I can't check for execute. So, and this doesn't work. This should work, that preview. Print preview. I should fix that, but it says okay, I can't execute it, so why would I add it to the menu if I can't execute it anyways? So that's basically pretty cool, but there are some errors here, but where I actually allow it to check for execute but don't actually execute it, so I need to really remove the stuff that it shouldn't be able to execute. I just misunderstood that. So for example, the print preview, it's actually allowed. If you look at the GNOME shell nano, and then go to G shell. And then go to the check executes. Then Evince preview, see? It is allowed to execute it, to check for execute, so it will show it up. Now, this actually, even preview exactly, should probably, we confined that at least. So we should probably allow GNOME shell to execute that. So, even prev. Although, actually, that's not done yet. So, actually, that's weird. Oh yeah, I actually execute that in the events domain. So how do I do that? Events, I actually run that in the events domain. So let's go to events, see how that's set up. Allow. So that's an entry point. Event prints is an entry point to events. So GNOME shell runs events, I guess, and that's already there. So. So that's messy. So basically, GNOME shell runs events prev. confused with how we could do that. So, this is just evens. This is. Back to actually, this is already allowed. It's just this part here. This is probably already. So when GCL runs even, it can run events, preview exactly. Let's just make this run events. See if that makes it work. Not quite. And why is that? Overlooking something. Print preview. I'm assuming that that's events print preview. That's all I'm getting. I don't see how that would be blocking it. I don't see how that would be blocking it. See? That doesn't wouldn't make sense. Nothing else. Is there's no other oven stuff, at least not there. Weird. That's weird. That's just weird. Why isn't it running it? Doesn't even work in permissive mode. So that's not it. It's just buggy. It's just buggy. Nah, anyways, a lot of this stuff seems to work. There's a lot of bugs in there as well, but all the stuff that you see here, the frequency, you are enabled to, you can run, but everything you don't see, everything you can't run, you don't see. At least that's the main idea. There are some inconsistencies there, for example settings, you see it here, but you can't actually run it. So it's not perfect, but it's better than nothing. And that ISO rut, that's I should just remove that from the KinExec, and then it will also be. G-shell. So if I remove that from here, the games. Games, and I make this exact type. Then it won't show up. I'm not sure why console helper is there. Probably remove that as well. Actually remove everything that for example TCC center could remove that T boxes I could remove that evolution I could remove that for now preview I can now remove that and the next sec moment yet and then empty contacts and day and dub. I can remove day and dub because that's already allowed. Anyways. Or actually no. No, this might actually. Clean it up a little bit. Damn. Oh, exact type. Exact type T. Exact type. So that it only shows the stuff that you actually. I might need to log out to actually. To actually see that, the difference. And even then there might be some stuff cached. So 13, 13, 13. So now. Even less. And you can see that it removed a lot of stuff. And Eclipse, I should remove Eclipse. But Eclipse is. I'm not sure why Eclipse is in there. But that's pretty cool. So you can make it show only the stuff that you can run. And then when you actually run more stuff, you get more icons. So that's pretty neat, actually. But why is Eclipse in there? I don't understand that. This. Oh, this, yeah. This isn't right. This isn't right. I need to remove this stuff here. But that will bring up new stuff. Same goes for this here. Oh, actually, not this one. But why? Does Eclipse show up? G-Docs shouldn't show up either. I don't know why. It shows up. Maybe it's in cache somehow. Maybe it's due to. There's a lot of stuff in here. that isn't right. Here, for example, this desession exec. Not sure why Eclipse is showing up. Let's have a look at 13:13. Okay, 13:13, didn't I say that? Now, hopefully I haven't broken anything since then. We have a signal though, two signals. DFSD network and DVFS DNSD. DVFS, the network. I'll just paste that in there. and DNS SD. GVFSD DNS SD. So that's actually interesting, but also confusing, especially since I didn't realize that stuff from the beginning. I still don't understand why Eclipse is in that list. Well, I'm logging out. Removing some stuff. Kill all. You my login user, and then clear my login user shell. So I hope you know what I'm talking about, because else then this wouldn't make sense at all. So let's see what we have. So now we have actually only two here. And frequencies are none, because it's clear. So DNS sec trigger, Eclipse is still popping up. I don't know why. See, it won't run. So Light, actually that's it. So this is actually mislabeled. This is actually mislabeled. Yeah, that's mislabeled, so I'll need to fix that. Others similar stuff. Oh yeah, here, this is so user lipe, I guess. This is just, let's just make this binty for now, and that's why it's showing up, because it can actually execute mmap lipes, so that's why it's showing up. But it can't actually run it. But there were other things, weren't there? So that's why I basically dismissed this. But the DNS sec trigger, it's also not DNS sec trigger. I should look at that as well. DNSSECMON. So should remove that as well. But isn't that that applet? Actually, so you should be able to run that from GNOME as well, I guess. it's getting really, really messy. But yeah, you need to, sometimes you need to take a step back to be able to take a few steps forward. But I like that feature with those checks, actually. I just didn't realize that it worked that way. Okay. Oh yeah, restore con that sucker. That's sad. Let's try run this. Doesn't seem to do anything. So annoying, I can't, for some, I can't get that thing up. It used to be intuitive, but now I just can't get that thing up for some reason. So, I don't know what the hell is going on. DNS sec. Trigger. Oh, see, it's just. Oh, yeah, and I'm not allowed to kill it. Fuck. Okay, that sucks. But yeah, so basically, I don't know why GNOME would want to. Show that up. The DNS trigger thing. I'm going to log out. Kill all. And then just do a fresh run. Christ sakes. Kill all. Clear. And then out search MABCTS. 13, 3, 2. Okay, we're clean. So let's just log in again. And that's the wrong password, I guess. So hopefully now it's okay. So this is really the minimum desktop where everything has a is allowed. Or allowed. Everything that you see here is functional actually. And what you don't see is not functional. So everything that's not functional that you won't see except for example here, because it somehow can't remove that. So now that's actually pretty neat. That is actually pretty neat. So yeah, that's a cool feature. Really cool feature. And I didn't know that before, but that's what I figured out then today. And yeah, this DNS set trigger thing. One thing I hate is that I can't seem to get that thing here to pop up. Some reason it just doesn't work. Isn't there a way for me to force that? Guess not. So yeah, fully functional desktop actually, or at least pretty fully functional. Nice. Okay, I'm going to leave it at this because I can talk about this forever, I guess. I'll just leave this open. And let's have a look at AC now. Oh, it's clean. So that's neat.